The topic is the role of AI in the pandemic, and my guest is Rob Valdez. He is Director of Cybersecurity and Automation Services with Kaufman Rossen. Rob, welcome.
Thank you very much for having me, Robert. It's a pleasure.
So what is the role today of artificial intelligence, of AI, in navigating the pandemic?
Artificial intelligence is capable of a lot of different types of things. From what we're seeing, people make use of it now in the pandemic when budgets and resources and time and uncertainty matters more than ever. Primarily, we're seeing people focus on automation and insight. They're looking for ways to automate routine tasks to try and gain productivity and then gain additional insight for things like sales trends and budgeting and demand and any kind of inventory forecasts that they may need to. So it's all kind of tied together for what's being used today.
Is AI a newcomer to the area of pandemic and risk management and the like, or has it been around with us for a while?
Yeah, AI can be a bit of a tricky term. It sort of depends on who you ask. But AI can either simulate intelligence and attempt to automate those things, or it can be new things that we've never thought of before. And so if you sort of lean on that first definition, simulating intelligence, looking for learning, those kinds of things, then AI has been incrementally getting more and more powerful for decades, as a matter of fact. And it's just now there are some additionally even more exciting things that are becoming available, which is causing the term to receive some new life again.
Yeah, I realize it's a little bit of a dicey term because it encapsulates so much. There's also this issue of analytics. I don't think that they are exactly the same thing, but they do go hand in hand. I mean, is analytics the data that is fed into an AI machine, or where does it fit in and how is that relevant to our discussion today?
Great question. Analytics, if you have to sum it up in a single sentence, analytics is turning data into knowledge into value, right? So you take data from a bunch of different sources, whether it's financial data or shipping and logistics information or purchasing and procurement or budgets or all kinds of receiving and those sorts of things. You create some kind of a model of knowledge that represents the way that your company understands that data. And then you make good decisions based on that. That's the analytic process. And so analytics sort of describes that entire process.
The assumption being, I think the term sort of carries along the assumption that we're talking about too much data these days for a human being to make sense of. Therefore, you do need a machine because of just the sheer complexity and volume of data. Would that be correct to say?
Yeah, that's a big part of what's been happening for the past 10 years is people gain additional insight into data. Maybe things only used to be on paper copies, stuffed in drawers and floating around the warehouse. And now you've got a lot more digital information that's able to be wrangled and organized and then probed and shine a light into to get that knowledge to make those better decisions. And that's why this big data has become more a part of the conversation every single year and why there's additional value being found there that wasn't previously available.
And capturing the human expert. I mean, early on in the days of AI, we talked a lot about so-called expert systems, the idea being that they were supposed to mimic the amount of knowledge that human beings acquire over their careers. But now, of course, we're talking about far more information than any human being in a lifetime could ever actually amass, correct?
That's right. And especially now in the time of the pandemic, that people are relying on cloud services and relying even more on digital information, that data is becoming more and more aggregated and hopefully more and more available for that type of insight. But again, that contributes to that sort of big data and mass issue, and analytics is the process of shining that light into there to gain knowledge, which we're able to help clients do by either creating managerial dashboards to gain additional insight into budgets and into demand, or by automating those routine processes with spreadsheets that have messy data all over the place.
Well, thanks for bringing it back to the pandemic, because I do want to get back to that and get a more specific idea of just how AI can serve companies in this particular environment today. I'm not asking for you to name any companies, but I'd like you to, if possible, give me a generic situation whereby AI is directly contributing to a company's ability to get through this particular pandemic situation right now.
Yeah, absolutely. So there is a manufacturing company that has had some difficulty really gaining some insight into their sales and their demand, and therefore also forecasting what's going to happen. There's a lot of uncertainty down here in South Florida where we are. There's a lot of uncertainty around construction, a huge industry that's very important. And so a lot of people are really trying to say, okay, let me look at my best scenario, let me look at my worst scenario, my most probable scenario, and make good planning and decisions today based on those different scenarios. And so we're able to help create those dashboards using the existing data today, but then also model a couple of additional scenarios that may come to fruition and mm-hmm. help that person plan, both plan for the worst, but also prepare for the best to make sure they can exploit those scenarios. And so by gathering that type of accounting information and making reasonable forecasts and informed decisions, we're able to help our clients use that sort of information.
Interesting you're putting it that way, because you're saying essentially that AI is not merely reactive in a situation such as this, it is proactive. So are companies able to use AI, for instance, to create so-called what-if scenarios, scenario modeling of potential pandemics in the future and get an idea, then prepare for it in that way?
Yeah, that's a big part of sort of the promise of AI, right? Not only the summary of what's happened in the past, not only diagnosis of what's happening today, but mm-hmm. then sort of like predictions and prognosis and helping prescribe what we can do in the future to help plan for those different scenarios. That's really a big part of the promise of what AI is presenting right now, mm-hmm. both to clients that are small businesses with some basic tools, but then also clients that are huge enterprises, which have very involved models that pull from all different sources of information.
Okay. Well, then let's talk about, though, the reactive part of it, or this of the moment type of situation, because companies are under constant attack from hackers, from phishers, from ransomware and the like. How can AI help a company just protect itself against those attacks? If those attacks happen, how can it help them to deal with it?
Yeah, there's a whole broad variety to address a large amount of threats that we're being presented with right now. Unfortunately, we're actually seeing that ransomware is receiving more attention by attackers. Again, it's mm-hmm. devastating, but they know right now people are critically relying on their computer infrastructure and on their cloud resources. And as a result of that, they go to where it hurts most, right? There was a very large attack that got publicized over the past weekend that took down a household name, and it was very devastating. And so attackers are doing this, and we can respond with all different types of automation and tools. There are tools that are as sophisticated as recognizing all different unseen signatures and unseen software before that mm-hmm. can be purchased on the marketplace. But then there's also a lot of robotic process automation and process sequences that can be automated over and over and over, checking for different kinds of alerts, blacklisting things that shouldn't be there, whether it's in your firewall or your email gateway, responding mm-hmm. to tickets and triaging those things so that you can pay the most attention to the things that are most important right now. Mm-hmm. So there's a big umbrella of tools that are available, but people need to find exactly what fits their specific scenario and understand their risk as it is right now. And unfortunately, during the pandemic, it appears to be very high and perhaps escalating.
Well, I guess you could say that given the fact that these attacks continue, that AI has not solved the problem, and whether that's because companies have yet to embrace the solutions that are on the marketplace or the solutions themselves need to be more sophisticated, I don't know which it is, but clearly these things are still happening.
Yeah, these things are definitely still happening. And let's be honest, the tools are only as good as the decision making of the people whose hands they're in, right? Mm-hmm. So it really still requires, just like it always has, sophisticated, informed, thoughtful management, taking a proactive view on what their actual risk scenario is, and then responding in kind, commensurate to that scenario. So understanding specifically what's their risk right now, and what's their highest priorities based on those risks. That's why, regardless of how technology changes, that process of risk assessment and analysis is perennial. It needs to be performed whether every year just to update it, or especially on change of environment and status events like a worldwide pandemic that threatens the very way we do business.
Always comes down to people. But I imagine you would think, though, that the AI system is going to get smarter. It learns. That is the very nature of it. It'll, as the years go by, it'll become more sophisticated and take over more processes and become more effective, correct?
The truth is these tools are getting very, very impressive. And so now a lot of the decision making becomes around understanding and validating those tools that you have in place, making sure they're configured and doing exactly what you're expecting them to do so that you're definitely getting your money's worth, right? I mean, you're still talking to a CPA here. I'll be a technologist. Mm-hmm. We want to make sure we're getting our value out of these tools, right? So validating what's in place and then identifying those gaps to understand exactly making sure that your dollar can carry you as far as you need it to go and keep making those good decisions.
Human intelligence is needed to figure out whether artificial intelligence can get the job done. But it sounds like it is a very effective technology, and there's a lot more ahead in the future that's exciting. But Rob Valdez, thank you so much for helping us to understand where we are today and how smart or not smart machines are getting in helping us through the pandemic. Thank you very much for being with us. Appreciate it.
Thank you, Robert. It's been a pleasure.